Look, I mean, here's the reality, right? Look around you today. Everything in your line of sight right now is the product of intelligence. Humans collectively, individually, have created everything that you see around you. And so the potential to take what has made us special, our intelligence, and try to automate that, paralyze it, speed it up, and make it widely available to billions of people on the planet is, I think, one of the most exciting missions that we could possibly do. So I think that's very reasonable for us to think over the next 10 to 20 years, this is going to be the greatest leap forward in productivity that our species has ever known, probably more so than the Industrial Revolution. If it's anything like electricity, and many people have been comparing it to that, then you'll see it absolutely everywhere, in every device, on every platform, in every part of your life.
And what implications could these advancements hold for us as individuals, for our societies, and for our understanding of what it means to be human?
So many things are being said now about AI, but I think there are two things that every person should know about AI. First is that AI is the first tool in history that can make decisions by itself. All previous tools in history couldn't make decisions. This is why they empowered us. You invent a knife, you invent an atom bomb. The atom bomb cannot decide to start a war, cannot decide which city to bomb. AI can make decisions by itself. Autonomous weapon systems can decide by themselves who to kill, who to bomb. The second thing is that AI is the first tool in history that can create new ideas. The printing press could print our ideas, but could not create new ideas. AI can create new ideas entirely by itself. This is unprecedented. Therefore, it is the first technology in history that instead of giving power to humans, it takes power away from us. And the danger is that it will increasingly take more and more power from us until we are left helpless and clueless about what is happening in the world. And this is already beginning to happen in an accelerated pace. More and more decisions about our lives, whether to give us a loan, whether to give us a mortgage, whether to give us a job, are taken by AI. And more of the ideas, of the images, of the stories that surround us and shape our minds, our world, are produced, are created by AI, not by human beings.
You know, these are deep questions, and you know, we call this alignment. You know, one way we think about how do you develop AI systems that are aligned to human values and including morality. This is why I think the development of this needs to include not just engineers, but social scientists, ethicists, philosophers, and so on. And I think we have to be very thoughtful, and I think these are all things society needs to figure out as we move along. It's not for a company to decide.